delayed some real progress. A little while ago, I called up Secretary Clinton and congratulated her and her staff for the victory here in Nevada. They ran a very aggressive, effective campaign, and I applaud them for their efforts. What this entire campaign has been about is the issue of momentum, is the issue of bringing more and more people into the political process. When we began in Iowa, we were 50 points behind. When we began in New Hampshire, we were 30 points behind, and we were way behind here in Nevada. But what I think is happening is that as people hear our message, and it's a tough message because it speaks to the truth of an American society today that a lot of people just don't want to address. And that is the fact that we have a corrupt campaign finance system which is undermining American democracy and must be billionaires and their PACs to continue to buy elections in the United States of America. And the American people are catching on that we have a rigged economy. Ordinary people, working people, working two or three jobs longer and longer hours, and almost all new income going to the top 1%. And together we are going to create an economy that works for all of us and not just the top 1%. And the American people are catching on that we have a broken criminal justice system.
Yes.
A system which says today that some kid in Nevada or Vermont gets picked up with some marijuana, that kid will have a police record staying with him his entire life. If you are a Wall Street executive and your illegal behavior destroys the economy and the lives of millions of people, somehow nothing happens to you. And our job is to bring justice back to the criminal justice system. I want to thank all of our supporters here in Nevada. I want to thank our thousands of volunteers, including many of you, for working tirelessly. I want to thank our staff for the great job that they have done. I am especially proud that here in Nevada, we're seeing this all over this country, we are bringing working people and young people into the political process in a way we have not seen for a very long time. In a short while, I'll be on a plane to South Carolina, and then we're going to be competing in 11 states all across this country on Super Tuesday. And I believe, Super Tuesday, we have got an excellent chance to win many of those states. I also know that on Super Tuesday and before, we are going to be taking on a very powerful and well-funded super PAC, a super PAC that receives significant amounts of money from Wall Street and wealthy special interests. So as we head to Super Tuesday, we would very much appreciate the support of the American people who have been so kind and generous. We have received at this point over 3.7 million individual contributions. And if people want to help us out, they can do that at BernieSanders.com. Lastly, as I think everyone knows, taking on the establishment, whether it is the financial establishment, whether it is the political establishment, whether it is the media establishment, is not easy. We have come a very long way in 9 months. It is clear to me, and I think most observers, that the wind is on at our backs. We have the momentum. And I believe that when Democrats assembled in Philadelphia in July at that convention, we are going to see the results of one of the great political upsets in the history of the world.
Nevada,